The Honorable Governor of Assam, Professor Jagadish Mukherjee, Sri Atul Bora, Honorable Minister for Agriculture, Sri Kamakya Prasad Thasa, Member of Parliament, Dr. D. Ramaya, Director CSIR and NAST Jorhat, Senior Scientists, Research Fellows, and my dear students. I am extremely happy to be admitted today. In fact, I came for Agriculture University Golden Jubilee celebration. Then I expressed a desire that I also would like to visit some of the scientific research institutes, technological research institutes, wherever they are. After becoming Vice President, I have made a mission to go around the country, visit universities, research centers, IITs, IIMs, IIITs, IESR, and also various laboratories to acquaint myself of what is happening on the research front, what is happening on technology front, and also to know what are the new innovations they are making, how they are functioning, what are the problems they are facing, and then to also, wherever possible, to interact with the students and understand their aspirations and challenges. I was there yesterday in IIM Shillong. Morning I was there for the Golden Jubilee of Jorhat Agriculture University. Tomorrow I am there in Guwahati for a state government insurance health cover program. And afternoon I am there in Manipur. Manipur also I will be visiting some of your labs and also addressing the agriculture university students there. The idea is to upgrade my knowledge, to upgrade my understanding, and also to get reassurance of the future of the country and development of the country. I would have gone there to this research people's hostel. There would have been no problem. But for the schedule that I have to go to the other side and again catch the flight. I'm very happy that I laid foundation online for this building. In the future, everything is going to be online. There won't be any need to stand in line. That is the line of the government. But at the same time, at the end of the day, someone has to be there at the ground level, grassroots level, to see personally and also to implement them in an effective manner. The mandate given to your institute is effective use of the immense material resources that are available in the Northeast region. That's the mandate. Whatever is, whether it is petroleum, whether it is natural gas, whether it is minerals, whether it is tea, whether it is aromatic and medicinal plants, or whatever it is, how to make best use of them, how to take care of Mother Earth, and how to make people's life comfortable. The very purpose of science and technology is to make people's life comfortable. That is the core agenda of these institutions. A Northeastern region is a gift of the God to the country. You have so much beauty, so much greenery, so much cleanliness, and also so many good people. You have to really focus on that, and I am happy the Government of India, led by Sri Narendra Bhai Modi, has been focusing more attention. You must be seeing more and more ministers coming here, more and more central leaders visiting. Donor also is becoming active. A lot of activity is there, focus is there on the Northeast. Because this area, which is in the border, which has got a typical character of ups and downs, adverse conditions, we must see to it that the development reaches this far east, northeast region. That's the priority of the government. My mission to come to northeast also is that, to see myself what is happening and also to encourage. See, the science and technology, science is for betterment of the people. and technology is also for development of the people. But the technology has to be transferred, transferred to the needy, transferred at all levels. So we, these institutes, I feel they have been doing good work. They need to improve further. They need to focus more on skill development of the region. We have good manpower, willing younger generation to join the national mainstream and work. So you have to really focus more on skill development. I saw some of the presentations. You need to do much more. In that you have to co-opt donor. You must also work with the Northeastern Council. You must also work with the state governments, because there should not be duplication. There should be proper integration of the activities of the Government of India, scientific institutions, and also state government, and also other bodies. We should not work in solos. That's my advice number one. Number two, these institutes should become friends of the local farmers. We must educate them about the new technology, new ideas. And then we must also become a guide to the farmers. Whenever there is a problem, farmers should come to these labs. And labs should go to the farmer, rather than just sitting in a room and then doing your research and all. Because the farmers are also are working scientists. Not that you are not working scientists, they are working in the field. You are working in the lab. That is the difference. So the scientists who are working in the field and the scientists who are working in the lab, there has to be coordination, there has to be cooperation, there has to be exchange of ideas. And then also, you should, at the end of the day, you should become friend of the people. What is the advantage the Northeastern region or the Jorhat or the Assam got on account of location of this lab? Is it only a few buildings? Is it only a few employment opportunities? No. It is enrichment of knowledge. It is transfer of knowledge. It is proper utilization of the locally available material and men. That should be your goal. And then also self-help groups which are formed by the state, they need to be encouraged. I was shown some self-help groups, what they are preparing, how they are marketing and all. It should be done in a much bigger way. But what is required for the self-help groups is you need to give them brand. You need to really integrate them with big companies, because in our country, brand still has some value. So you need to create brand value for that. You need to provide them credit. The banks should provide them credit. The Prime Minister's Mudra Yojana. And also now the new generation and all, instead of standing for employment, they want to stand on their own. That's why the Prime Minister came out with this idea of stand-up, start-up, start-up and stand-up. Earlier stand-up during our old days, younger days was, when you go late to school, stand up on the bench. Now the Prime Minister is saying, stand up on your own legs. That is the key for the future. Because India is a vast country, 130 crore people. 65% of the people of India are below 35 years. We have aspirational India. Everybody wants to become something. They just do not want to become a Sarkari Karmachari. Nothing wrong in becoming Sarkari Karmachari, but standing on our own, it gives you more confidence, more respect, more recognition. That's why this startup and stand-up and the skill development, self-help groups, you should all integrate with them and you should be a guiding center for such activities. Then coming back, the small things we are all importing. It's really a shame. Small things we are importing. Potato chips we are importing. We produce potato, we export it, and then they are made into chips and then put a brand. And nowadays I am told they are not even being exported. They are just cut into pieces and then made into fried and then put in a packet and put a brand name. Because Indian people, we have a weakness. Because of colonial rule, something foreign always attracts the mind. Whether it tastes good or not, made in London, made in America, made in New York and all. I remember during my school days, college days, I was discussing with one of my colleagues about Ramayana, the greatness of Ramayana, etc. He said, "Theek hai, isme kya hai special?" So then we went for vacation. After I came back from vacation, we were again discussing. There was a film also came, Ramayana, at that time. I mean, he was saying, oh, Naidu, Ramayana is really great, yaar. I said, what happened to you? In between, did Rama come in our dreams? He said, no, no. During holidays, one person came from America. He gave a lecture about Ramayana, how beautiful it is, how great it is. Unless a foreigner tells him the greatness of Ramayana, he is not able to appreciate. That is our weakness. Potato chips, tomato ketchup, small things, even the mushrooms, even the small things we can make. The other day, my shoe size is a little bigger, 11 plus. So I'm not able to get proper shoes. So I told one of my friends in Andhra who used to give me, Babu, is there anybody in Delhi? He said, yes, I know many people. And then he sent one fellow. And he came, and then he took measurements. And next day, or the second day, he made it and brought it. Then I told him, bhai, itna jaldi aapne banaya, kya hai, aapka technology kya hai? Sir, I supply to Reebok, sir, he said. Reebok people are using his shoes and putting their name and selling it to Indians. So you have the talent. If you give little upgradation and little credit and little support and little brand name, it excels. So we have to really focus on that. And in the coming, I just now saw the brick manufacturing unit, bricks. Brahmaputra, you have a lot of opportunity. So if environmentally also it will be useful. If you, without polluting the air, you can go for this sort of brick manufacturing. I'm told it's 4 rupees dot, whereas the other one is 10 rupees. And there was no environmental side effect. Small idea, but small idea, small is beautiful. And if you make it beautiful, it will become mightyful. So that we have to understand on those lines and encourage such activities. Investment is some 35 lakhs. Banks can give that money. And now Mudra Bank, the Prime Minister the Prime Minister has come out with new ideas, banking the unbanked, funding the unfunded, recognizing the unrecognized, reaching the unreached. That is the goal of the Prime Minister. So taking advantage of it, we must approach the MPs and the ministers, local administration, see to it that the banks give funding to these people. Timely credit, affordable credit is also very much needed for development. Friends, I don't want to take much of your time. This, as I said, the science is for comfortable life. Science is for happiness. Science is for empowerment. Technology is for enlightenment. Technology is for enablement. Technology is for development. If you join all these things together, there will be value addition. Value addition to the agricultural products. Value addition to the homemade products. If you do it, then you can really make people to stand on their own. And then we can become a stable, sustainable nation. So my suggestion to CSIR is, I will also tell the minister, Sri Jitendra Singh, Dr. Jitendra Singh, work with the donor, work with the NEC, and let there be coordination between the government agencies, central government and state government agencies, and put them to proper use so that whatever available here, the immense material resources of Northeast, they can be utilized. Lot of scope for vegetable growing, like mushroom, even other vegetables also, lot of greenery. Lot of scope for fisheries. Lot of scope for, I just now said it to the agriculture university people also. Fisheries, dairy. I am told there is no curd. Here I was surprised. I thought I will get a good curd. I was asking them. They are trying to please me with all other fish, different fishes. I said they were saying they have buttermilk. And I asked them, what do you call buttermilk? Sir, it's not that much familiar here. There is no equivalent name to buttermilk and all. Beautiful greenery. Grazing land, atmosphere, weather, all these things are available here. So dairy, fisheries, horticulture, floriculture, vegetables, mushrooms, a lot of things can be grown up here. And they can be sent now in the coming days. The connectivity is going to increase. We are seven sisters here, the seven states. We have seven brothers around us. Around the Northeast, you can directly reach them. So you can export vegetables, you can export many things. Our talent is superior to them. I went to Laos some time back and also Cambodia. I saw a center where we are all working together with regard to the, textile, this thing and all. In Vietnam, Cambodia, Laos, all these countries. And I found our things are more superior. So we can export. We can take advantage because of the continuity and also near someness. So keeping all these things in mind, I hope that this center here, CSIR, NEIST, will involve people and institutions much closer and then connect the science and technology for a brighter tomorrow and brighter future. That's my advice to all of you. As I told you, I just came here to see myself and also to pat you on the back for the good work you are doing. All these things should be done in a mission mode. Mission. What is the mission? Mission is to make India strong, stable. Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. This mission, this should be like a mission, not for commission. And there should not be any remission. And no omission also. We should all take this as a mission, life mission. Ramayya's mission. Others' mission. In my lifetime, I have achieved it. It's my new innovation. This has become useful to the people. That sort of satisfaction you must have. You are working for your satisfaction, not for mere salary. So that mission, missionary mood, missionary means I'm not talking to the other missionaries who are indulging in other activities. My suggestion of missionary is to take this as a mission and then train the people so that they can stand on their own. That's my advice. I'm happy that you gave me a good welcome here. And I am also happy to note the tremendous work done by the Institute right from its inception from 1961 as a multidisciplinary laboratory harnessing science for development. That's what you are doing. Congratulations to all of you. My compliments to the new generation. And thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.